Did you know that you can actually host a website on GitHub directly? This is something I recently learned about, and it's something I want to show you how to do in today's video. It's a feature called GitHub Pages, and essentially it allows you to use your repository code to host a website. So whether you have something for documentation or you want to host your own personal project that you're building on GitHub, GitHub Pages allows you to do that. So in today's video, I want to explain a little bit further about what this is. I'll show you step-by-step how to spin up your first site using GitHub Pages. And then at the end, we'll look at a pretty cool way to use GitHub Actions to automate this whole thing. So the first example we'll look at is how to create just a very basic website. And we're just gonna add one file, an HTML file, and see how we can host it. So as it says here, step one is to create a new repository. So if I go over to my GitHub page, new repository. So the only criteria in this scenario here is we need to name it with our username.github.io, where the username is my username or the organization that we're using on GitHub. In my case, I'll paste this in here, but instead of username, it's Hello KDS. It's the owner. It's also my username. So we'll keep it public and create repository. That's it for right now. Now, the next step is to, depending on what you're doing, is we're going to clone this locally. So copy this here, so it's already filled out for me. And in my local terminal, in my case, I'm using VS Code. The command is git clone, and I'll paste that URL in here, and it's empty. Obviously, we just created it. So here it is. And all we'll do, and as they recommend here, is just creating a simple file that says hello world. It's just an index file. So I'll just add it here, index.html. But in this case, you know, you could make this as complicated as you want with HTML and CSS, probably add some JavaScript as well. It's the only caveat here is you can't have a database connection. It's for a static website. So in our case, we're just going to say hello world just to get this going. And we're going to then add, commit, and push the changes. So first let me change directories into this. Now we'll do git add, all of them, git commit, initial commit. That's a typo, missed the, added an extra space here. Let's get rid of that. And now git push, and I'll just do origin head. And it's a little different from this, but that's just how I do it. And now it should be pushed directly to our repository. I know we went through that pretty quick. And here we can see it went right to main, index.html, and we have our site here. And we can see actually right away, this dot is indicating that there's an action running. And if we go to actions, we can see it's going through something here. So automatically it recognizes that you are pushing to a branch with this specific naming convention, and it automatically starts building your site for you. I didn't even have to set anything up, and it starts going for right away for you. So while this is happening, I'm going to go to settings, and I want to show you where this all is set up. So within settings on your repository, you can go to pages, and in here it says, okay, your site is ready to be published. Here's the URL, and we matched the default URL, so it kind of all starts working behind the scenes, and you can pick which branch your pages site is being hosted from. So right now it's just, we push just to main, so it's recognizing main, and it's just the root folder. But as we'll see later in this video, it's actually a good practice to have a specific branch just for your GitHub pages. And that's where you can select the branch and it'll pull those files. So you can keep it separate from your code if maybe it's, let's say, for a documentation of a site or something like that. And here's where you can do some built-in themes, but we'll touch on that in the next section here. So let's go back to actions. We can see this completed. It just took 2 minutes and it deployed this site. And what I'm going to do is open a new private window just to make sure nothing is still there. Paste this URL in here and there it is. We can see hello world. It's just that basic site that was built and it's public for anybody to look at. So at this point we've created a simple website through our GitHub repository and it's public for anybody to use. At this point, you could build this out and be as creative as you want with your HTML and your CSS and all that stuff. But another great feature of GitHub and GitHub Pages is the fact that it comes built in with that template of Jekyll. And so let's see how we can do this. And just to show you this fully, What I'm going to do is delete this repository, and we're just going to start over. So let's go ahead and delete this. And let's just do it again. So I'm going to recreate the same name, public. And the reason I'm doing this is just to start from a blank slate to show you how the templates work. Because when you do it initially, it does give you a default file, which is helpful to just see what this all looks like. So here we are. We're back to the basic empty repository. But rather than doing this through the terminal, what I'm going to do is go right to settings, pages. And right now, you know, it's empty. We haven't done anything with pages. It doesn't recognize any files here. But what we can do is go to choose a theme. And again, this is a tool called Jekyll. It's templating kind of thing for a website. So you can make it a little bit nicer. And there's different themes we can use. Let's just select this one. So if we do select theme, then this is the file I was talking about. It's going to put it right in our main directory here. And it just gives you something kind of cool to look at. So let's go ahead and select commit changes. So now our code not only has this in this markdown file, but also it comes with a config file that is indicating what the theme we selected is. In our case, it's minimal. And if you wanted to pick something else or switch it, this is where it would switch and you do all that stuff with it and all that. So let's go to actions here and we can see, again, right away, it just runs that built-in action. It recognizes what we're doing. It'll take about a minute or two to deploy. And we would expect to see this deployed with, you know, that markdown file now and with some links built in. So let's do new private window, get ourselves ready. All right, so now this deployed again. So let's copy this link and go back again. And now we can see it looks like this. So it's a little bit nicer again because it's using that markdown file, but what we can do here is that, you know, you can just see kind of some ideas of what you can do here. And it also gives you a link to Jekyll. So again, this is what's built in with GitHub Pages. This is an option for you, and you can do all sorts of stuff, make it more dynamic without a database, but you can build something like a blog or something, you know, a little bit more than just maybe a few pages. But there's a lot of use cases here for your own custom site or one built through Jekyll, which I think is a pretty cool feature. Again, it's built in with GitHub, so you can host your portfolio, make a blog, whatever you want. Now, the last thing I want to go through here is specific to documentation. And this is something that, at least in the data world, is becoming more and more popular. And a tool that we like to use that I cover a lot on this channel is DBT, Data Build Tool. And one of the features in that is a documentation. It hosts a website. And a lot of times it can be kind of tricky to figure out where you want to host that. So what I'll show you here is how you can use Pages to host your DBT documentation. But again, you could do this for pretty much anything that you wanted. So here's an example of a DBT project that we've worked on in the past. And I have it copied locally here as well. So if we open up here in Visual Studio Code, here is the DBT training. And if you're not familiar with DBT, essentially it's a data transformation tool. You can run a couple commands to put together some HTML and website files within this target directory. So we want to deploy this target directory as GitHub Pages. But because this is going to be constantly changing, we also want to be able to automate this. So we're going to do two things at once here. We're going to update our GitHub workflows so that we can automatically deploy our GitHub Pages based on those files, but also have it create a separate branch and pull from this target directory altogether. So let's see how we can do this. So the first thing I'll do is check out a new branch. And if we double check, we are now on this branch. So what we'll do again, we're going to update our already existing workflow file here that we have, but do it in a way that allows us to automatically deploy a new version of our documentation. And the way we're going to do this is if we look at the marketplace for actions, one of the options we have is one for deploy to GitHub Pages. There's a few of them that you can use, but this is just an example that I found that works and that I like. So as it says here, it can be used to push your production ready code to any branch you'd like, including this GH Pages, which is a default one. Just getting right to it, what we want to do is include some of this logic within our workflow file. And all this will start to make sense once you see it in action. So one thing I'm going to add here is this permissions content write. So I'll add this under here. Check out V3. We have V2, so we can update this. We'll set up Python, install DBT. These are things that are required for DBT for this particular tool to work, but if you have something else, obviously this could be different. And instead of doing a full run of this tool, what we're going to do is we'll say compile docs, and the commands we want are dbt docs generate. Don't worry too much if you're not familiar with this. Ultimately, this is the command within this tool to compile our code and create this website, these website files. So now what we want to do is include this part right here so that we can use this act to deploy this as a website. And it'll reference this. In our case, instead of the folder build, we don't have a build folder. Like we said, we want to use this target folder. So we'll do target. So essentially what's going to happen here is this will compile and create some website files within this target directory. And then this is going to look within that target directory and move it to a new branch called GH pages and use that to deploy our code. Just to make sure we can see this run on our test branch once we push this, I've added this right here on push to this branch, which is the one we've just made. So it should run as soon as we check this in and push it. Okay, so let's save. So to push this forward, we'll do a git add all, git commit, add a commit message. We'll say update workflow, and then git push origin head to get it up to our branch. Now, because we added this condition here to push, we should expect to see this action already runs. So let's go ahead and go back to our repo here and let's refresh. And we can see this is already logged. If we go to branches, we could see this dot here. That is an indication that there is some sort of action running. So that was triggered. Let's go check this out. Let's click through to actions and see what's happening here. So we'll let this go through. It's going to run a couple of dbt commands. And then ultimately, when it gets to deploy, deploy is what we called the step for deploying our pages. So we should see this then do something for that. And here we go. We can see GitHub pages, deploy action. So it went through. And if we take a look at what happened here, ultimately, it's creating a new branch. It created one just for this workflow and assigned it to GitHub pages. So it's committing to a new branch called GitHub pages, and that's where it's going to deploy these files to a new branch. So we would expect to see a new branch somewhere called GitHub pages, and here it is, updated 1 minute ago. And if we look at this, this was created from our workflow, and here are all the files that were compiled from dbt and then, you know, pushed from this action. So we have our index and all sorts of other stuff in here. And ultimately what we want to do now is point our pages to this branch, to this file. So let's go to settings. We'll do just like we did before, pages. And it says it's ready to be published here, but we don't have anything there yet. And if we go to source, we can select git gh pages and just have it as this. So let's select save. And as soon as we do this, we would expect that previous action to be triggered, and here it is. It's building the pages and it's going to deploy it for us. And there it just deployed it. And we're going to open a new private window just to make sure we don't have any issues here. And let's take a look. And here is, again, at our link. And this is what the dbt docs site looks like, but it's hosted on GitHub. And essentially the way this is going to work is because we have this set to this page here, and we have this workflow here to always be looking for this target. Essentially, every time we run this, it's going to compile the latest version, move it to that branch through this action, and then because it will recognize there's an update to the branch, GitHub will refresh our pages, which will give us this here and then keep this constantly updated for us. So this is a really cool use case of GitHub pages and something that I think can save you a lot of time. And it's also nice because you don't have to set up any servers. You don't have to manage any of that. And if you want to add a custom domain, let's say you don't want it to just be, you know, this default, you can add a custom domain and have it based on whatever it is you're building from your GitHub pages as well. Hopefully now you have a good understanding of GitHub pages and can start using it on your own. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next week.